subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I'm Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand records and record types. So in our previous class, we have seen the memory hierarchy and the different types of storage devices that are available. So this entire section, we are going to discuss about physical database design. So which means that how the tables that we have seen so far, so the visualization that we had on the databases, like it is a set of tables, so informally, so how those set of tables will get stored onto the memory, how the data that is there on the databases will get stored onto the memory devices like hard disk, and how that data will get converted, will get buffered back to the RAM. So all those concepts we will try to understand all those concepts in this class. So coming to our previous class, we have discussed about the memory hierarchy and the memory devices. So if you haven't watched that video, please watch that video and come back here. So in this class, we will try to understand what is meant by a record and the different types of records that are available. So coming to the definitions, data in a database is regarded as a set of records organized into a set of files. So what does it mean is the data in the databases. So for example, if there are five different tables in the database, that those five different tables are considered as five different files. Each file consists of records, set of records. Records means rows. Each file contains a set of records. Each file is the data in the database is recorded as a set of records organized in a set of files. So every table is considered as a file, and that file consists of set of records. Okay, and each record contains of a collection of related data values. So each record, so this is what we call it as a record, and this entire table is considered as one single file. So in that file we contain records. So these are called as records. And each record consists of a collection of related data values or items. So each record is going to contain related data values or items, where each value is formed of one or more bytes and corresponds to the particular field of the record. So each record is going to have a specific values, some related values or items, and each value is formed out of a byte, one byte or more number of bytes. So if you take one alphabet as one byte, so each value in the record is going to have one or more number of bytes corresponds to a particular field of the record. So this is what we call it as a field, and informally we call it as column. Formally we call it as attribute, and this entire file is what we call it as table, and this entire row is what we call it as a record. Okay, so when coming to the memory storage, it is what we call it as a record, and the column is called as a field. Okay, so this table is considered when we are going to discuss about physical approach of the database, which means how these tables will get stored onto the memory. So if you try to understand how these tables are getting stored on the hard disk, then we consider every row as a record and every table as a file and every column as a field. So that is the meaning of this definition. Okay, so now Now each record, so there are different types of records. Those record types are of two types. It is fixed length record and variable length record. So whenever a row has to be stored onto the memory, that record can be a fixed length record or it can be a variable length record. So what does it mean? A fixed length record, if every record in the file has exactly same size. So this can be done. The storage of a record onto the memory can be done in two different types, which means every record can be of any of either of these types. It may be a fixed length record or a variable length record. So what is meant by a fixed length record? If every row is taken with a fixed number of bytes, so that is what we call it as fixed length record. What is the advantage of this fixed length record is if you start from here, the length of this field is going to be fixed. The length of this, the size of this entire record is going to be fixed, and the size of the field within the record is also going to be a fixed value. For example, if you take this record, this is one record space and each box is considered as one byte. Okay, so this is what we call it as a fixed record. You take any record in this table, any record, it is going to have fixed number of bytes. So which is what we call it as 33 number of bytes are considered to be there for every record in this table or in this file. So this is what we call it as fixed length record. What is the advantage of this fixed length record is, if you start from here, considering the first 10 bytes, we take it as name. So fetching the programs that are used to fetch the data from the record is very, very easy, because the length of each field in a record is also a fixed, and the length of every record in the file is also fixed. Okay, so these 10 bytes are considered for name, and 9 bytes are considered for SSN, and 2 bytes are considered for job code, and nearly 10 bytes are considered for 12 bytes are considered for department. So how we are going to take this assumption is based upon the maximum possibility for that field in a record, we are going to take this value as fixed length record. Okay, so this is how. What is the disadvantage with this? For example, if there is a possibility to have variable length fields within a record. So that we will try to understand. Whenever that kind of variable length fields within a record, some of the space will get wasted, which is not unused for some of the fields. Okay, so if you take name of an employee, the name of an employee is going to be a variable field. The size of the name of an employee will vary from one person to another person. So there is a variable length field within the record, so those kind of fields are going to waste some of the spaces. Okay, and if there are some fields which does not take values, for example, if you take department, so if the department has not been assigned to a particular employee, that field will be wasted as empty. So it is a variable length field. So this is a variable length field because the names of the departments are going to vary. So for example, if you take computers, the computers is going to take only 9 bytes. So it is a variable length field. Okay, in that case of variable length field, the memory will get wasted. And if there are no values for a specific field in a row, those will be considered as null values, and the entire space for that record, for that field in a record, will get wasted. So it is one of the disadvantages of this fixed length record. And to avoid that, we have another type of records called variable length record. So what is meant by a variable length record? So these spaces will not get wasted. So how that will get programmed, which means how those kind of records will get identified, how the length of the record will get identified is, the length of a field in a record will get identified is, it is done by a It is done by a field called separator. Separator means a separate kind of symbols are used to separate a variable length field in a record. If you take the name, name is a variable length record. For this variable length field in a record, for this record to get stored into the memory, the name field is going to occupy 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bytes of space, and one more byte of space will get occupied for any of these symbols. So this is what we call it as separator. Whenever the compiler, whenever the database management system software identifies these symbols, which should not be there within the values of the fields. Whenever the database management system software identifies question mark or this percentage symbol or dollar symbol, you can use any of them. So the compiler is going to decide. So if any of these separators are identified within the name field, which means that this is the end of this variable field, and this field is a variable field. Okay, so next is a fixed length field. If you take the SSN values, the numbers, the digits in an SSN is always fixed. Okay, you take Aadhaar number. So in our Aadhaar number, we have 4 threes, 12 number of digits. But if you take SSN, they are having 9 number of digits. Unique identification number is given 9 digits. So these 9 digits are fixed. And if you take job code, it is also a fixed. And this is a variable length field. So how to represent a variable length field? It is represented by a separator. It may be a question mark, a percentage symbol, or a dollar symbol. With this, we are going to identify that. With this, first field has been identified, and this is a fixed length field. Second field has been identified, third field has been identified, and with this separator, the fourth field will also get identified. With that, we are going to know that the first record has been read. Okay, so now what is a variable length record? If different records in a file have different sizes, so take here, so every row in the file is going to have 33 number of bytes. It is what we call it as fixed length record. And if you take a row in this type of organization, this row is going to have 29 bytes. And if you take this row is going to have 4 bytes for this, and for this it is 9 bytes and 2 bytes, and this is electronic means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 11. So this is going to take 11, 11 plus 2, 13, 13 plus 9, 22, 22 plus 4, 22 plus 4, 26 number of bytes are required for this first row. Okay. Because this organization is supporting variable length fields, which makes a variable length record. If the fields are variable, the record size is going to be varied. Okay, some of them are going to have more length and some of them are going to have less number of bytes required to store that record. So these are the two different types of organizations that are supported for the records in a file to be stored onto the memory. Okay, so this is what we call it as records and different types of records and the organizations that are used to store the records onto the memory. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.